Hey there, welcome to TV Groupie. It's Brian. I have the privilege and luxury, the pleasure, to have John Davey, a significant member of the Doctor Who team. He played various monsters, and I'm going to let him fill you in. Tell us who you are and tell us about your Doctor Who experience.
Hey there, everybody. My name is John Davey, and I am at the convention, which is Gallifrey 1. And I've been here for 3 days. It's absolutely fantastic. I think this is my fourth time here. And the reason why I am here is that back in 2005, I was fortunate enough to have played one of the Cybermen.
What are they?
Cybermen.
We did the 4 episodes in series 2 with David Tennant. Little did I know that 17 years and 50 episodes on, they're still squeezing me into those costumes. 2 years ago, when it happened last, kind of the major differences is that there were probably about half the attendees this year, obviously for safety reasons. But in some ways, it was a little bit less intense. You know, if there's 4,000 people around, it does get pretty mad, and there's a lot of wacky costumes that are absolutely amazing that people are wearing. And yeah, I've had a great time. I've done lots of panels. I've done like show and tell, behind the scenes exposés on my work on Doctor Who. And yeah, and I just love it. And obviously being from Britain as well, and it's February, this time in Britain, it's probably been about 6 months since we had warm, sunny weather. So any opportunity to come somewhere sunny as well is a bonus.
Were you a Doctor Who fan before you got called to be in Doctor Who?
Yes, I was. So I grew up, I'm showing my age now, watching Tom Baker's episodes back in the 1970s, which was absolutely fantastic. You know, you turn on the television and there's this like crazy tall guy with big hair and a huge personality, which is absolutely captivating for a young child. Mm-hmm. And yeah, then I left school, and this is what happens with most people, is you go to school and then they tell you, well, you should be doing this. You know, and as a kid, you're like, well, they're adults, they're grown up, they know better than me.
So they told you should become a monster?
No, well, they looked at my grades, which are non-existent, mm-hmm. and they're like, oh yeah, you just should be working on a construction site, just moving stuff from A to B. But I kept on chasing my passion. I was really into photography as a kid. Then eventually I started working. I started photographing weddings. I kind of got bored with that because I got no interest in other people's happy day, uh-huh. as such. And then I started making videos. And then eventually I worked for a video production company shooting music videos. So the company was called Collision Films, and we made music videos for Radiohead, the Scissor Sisters, the Killers. Most of them were all stop motion animation puppets, mm-hmm. You know, a bit like Tim Burton stuff. Yeah, then went on and shot commercials, various different things. A couple of years ago, 2020 was actually quite good because we did a lot of stop motion videos because you didn't need people. So we actually made 3 music videos for Cat Stevens. He re-released Tea for the Tillerman because it is the 50th anniversary. If you go on YouTube, go on his channel, we did Where Do the Children Play?
Another classic.
We did a bonkers, insane video, a stop motion video. And then we did Father and Son. And then we did a, because Tea for the Tillerman's only a minute long, we did a little music video for that as well. So that was really good. And then we also did a music video for Run the Jewels as well, called Walking in the Snow. And then filmed a commercial for John Lewis, which is like the big department store in Britain. And it's a kind of like, ooh, the John Lewis advert for Christmas is always a big thing. So I shot that.
What other TV do you watch? Anything?
Well, we in Britain, we do get influenced really heavily by American television. You know, it's a huge cultural thing. So as a kid growing up, You know, we all loved watching the A-Team, Airwolf, various different things like that. But I'm hugely into movies as well. So as a kid, I went to see Star Wars in the cinema, which totally blew my mind.
Yes.
So I was a huge Star Wars fan, Indiana Jones, and then, you know, those wacky comedies. Caddyshack is a big favorite of mine. Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
What about cartoons? Did you ever watch cartoons when you were growing up?
Yeah, as a very young kid, we had kind of the Warner Brothers and Looney Tunes.
Mm-hmm. Standards.
There was a thing as well that not a lot of people in Britain remember, but there was a cartoon called Laugh Olympics. I don't know if you remember that. So it was basically, they got all the Hanna-Barbera characters together, and they were basically competing at Olympic Games.
Okay.
Let me think. There was the Yogi Yahooies, the Scooby-Doos, and the Really Rottens.
Mm-hmm.
And they were all competing together.
And apparently you're a huge skateboarding, off-road skateboarding, four-wheel, electric, high-speed skateboarder. That's your new passion.
It is, yeah. So as a kid back in the 80s, skateboarding took off, and it was a huge phenomena. And then obviously you leave school and you have to grow up and do adult things, and then you realize, you know what, let's just have fun with life.
Yeah, and then become a monster.
And then become a monster. So,
okay, have you ever thought about being a cartoon character? Because you're about to be one.
Yeah, well, I've just found out about this process, so I'm going to certainly give that a go.
Hello there. My name is John Davey, and I'm at Gallifrey One in Los Angeles. I've just been here for an amazing Doctor Who convention, and the reason why I'm here is because I play the monsters. I've been working on the show since 2005, playing the Cybermen, Daleks, Ood, Jadoon, and many, many more. So I've been here meeting the fans, telling them my stories about being a hideous creature, and they've been loving it. It's been totally awesome. So thank you for listening to my stories and tuning in. Take care. Ooh-ah. And also, don't forget to watch TV Groupie. Take care. Bye-bye.